The Arctic is hot. Global climate change is doing its best to melt the glaciers and thaw the permafrost. The geographical location of the Arctic and the accessibility provided by the melting of the ice makes it strategically, security-wise, hot. The presumed existence of huge stores of oil, gas, minerals and gems makes it hot for explorers and exploiters also. Therefore, major international players, the Americans, the Russians, the Chinese and the EU, as well as some of the smaller states like Denmark, Norway and Canada, are trying to assert their interests or uphold sovereignty, for example, by increased military presence in the region. Recently, Donald Trump even suggested the US might buy Greenland off Denmark. Meanwhile, multinational corporations are themselves buying into the region, trying to establish themselves firmly to make the most of its untapped resources. A major snag, however, that keeps frustrating some of these major schemes is the fact that the Arctic is also home to about 4 million people. Spread across the entire region, they're trying to make the best possible living in these strange and changing circumstances. Among them are indigenous peoples, who are increasingly demanding recognition of their right to develop freely. They demand development which is designed by themselves according to their values and their cultures, and not, as has so often been the case, designed by outsiders. In spite of strong local identities and vibrant cultures, however, Arctic societies are dependent on few renewable and non-renewable resources. And therefore, they're also economically incapable of supporting, in most cases, political independence. Consequently, a main concern for these peoples in the Arctic remain development, but not at any cost. Most Arctic societies seek to harvest potential new areas of their economies while very much aware that development must also be sustainable, including, for example, environmentally and culturally sustainable tourism and resource development. So, lots of important issues to delve into for students at the Arctic Studies specialization. It provides an advanced understanding of the Arctic region and its relationship with the rest of the world in historical, social, political, and cultural contexts. Over two semesters, the specialization covers colonialism and intercultural encounters, indigenous rights, nation building and identity building politics, geopolitics and governance, and climate change and sustainable development. Hopefully, Arctic Studies is a specialization you might want to consider as the next element of your own education. Thank you very much, in any case, for your attention.